It is Saturday morning, the 13th of January, 2018. I am on my way to Ecuador. You wouldn't know it driving on this wintry road, but it's on my way to Vancouver. And then my flight is on Monday, but I wanted to leave a couple days to get myself I'll stay at my dad's in Vancouver. Maybe see my daughter. She's busy. On my way. Just went by the Monashee Summit sign, 1241 meter. Last time I did this drive was at night, so you guys couldn't really appreciate this stuff. Like, this is just beautiful. Pretty slick, pretty snow-covered, greasy in the corners. Really, really have to obey the yellow warning signs for speed and come down even more. It's just... go in the corner, and if you're late and you're braking, you're sliding across the road, so you can slide right into oncoming traffic or slide right off the road. So it's not the best driving conditions, but you know, I'm still doing 50 miles an hour, 60 miles an hour in the straight, you know, down to about 40, maybe 30 miles an hour in some of the corners, you know, for mile per hour people. 100 kilometers, 80 kilometers, 60, and 50. Like right here, you know, in the straight, you can get 100. But then you gotta really set up your corners just right. You gotta just be perfect. So, no daydreaming, that's for sure. But anyway, I'll shut up and just do a bit of driving and let you enjoy. Now you can see. The other night it was dirt dark, right? So I'm just going to get into Lumbee soon after I head the summit, just on the other side of the summit, the Monashee Summit. It looks like they're going down the middle and dropping a bit of salt and rock, so you know, I got one tire on pavement and the other one on snow, kind of, sort of, unless I drive in the middle of the road, which is possible when it's straight. It makes the truck go side to side more. I'd rather it just be bare or snow. Snow, you can saw your steering back and forth and you can keep control of your vehicle, but this has a tendency to just track your vehicle side to side. Like, I'm sure you're all aware. You know, you get into a slip slide, so it pulls, and then, you know, but you got one tire and good stuff, so it's not going to drag you across the pavement. But it just makes it for, it could be a little bit daunting, I imagine. But starting to warm up. Just took a little break, a little, see a man about a horse in the bush there, and it's warm, so probably when I get on, you know, on the other side, like, it'll warm up, I'll get to Kelowna, it'll probably be bare pavement when I get Vernon, Kelowna way, and then once I start for the connector to go to Merritt, it'll be a nightmare all the way to Hope, probably. And then I'll have to just deal with it as it comes. bad, though, you know. Could be much worse. You know, I think they're doing a fairly decent job of taking care of the roads. Opportune passing spot. Moby Dick. Now we just had fish and chips there. If you're in White Rock on the main drag here, you go to Moby Dick's to have a good fish and chips, because they were excellent. A little pricey, but you know, I had a two-piece, which is a three-piece. If you order two pieces, you get three pieces, and it was $16 with French fries. Okay, so I'm at the airport now. Had a day in Vancouver with my dad and his wife, and I was able to come here last night and pick up my daughter from her excursion to Kamloops, where she was, so I got to spend like 5 or 10 minutes with her, and then back here today on Monday the 15th of January 2018, just ready to start my excursion to Ecuador. Really easy through security. It was like they seemed to have their stuff together here, I must admit. It was quick. It just line kept slowly moving. You never like were waiting or, you know, and they were on people. They were, okay, boots, laptops, let's go, let's go. They were, it was almost like they were getting mad at people if they weren't, you know, adhering to the rules, which kind of made me kind of happy. Like, you know, you got to be in traveling mode. If you're stunned, you just, you're a liability. You know, I don't know. I've been traveling my whole life, so, you know, it's automatic, take my boots off, take my belt off, take everything out of my pockets, you know, so the thing doesn't go beep. Don't give them a reason to pull you aside. Don't give them anything. Don't forget your water. You know, it's unbelievable. Seeing people, like, just last minute, and they just make your life miserable when you do things like that, because they just pull you over and they make you go through, then they go through everything because you've made their life a little harder. But, very quiet right now. Flight's at 2 o'clock. I'm way early, but better be early than late. I don't like rushing when I'm at the airport. You know, just stress. You don't need it. But boy, this airport is busy. Vancouver is busy. But just to give you a heart attack, check this out. Duty free, right next to me. Not going to even walk in there. Check the price of the Johnny Walker. Johnny Walker garbage booze. Look, you know, even when I was drinking, I didn't drink that. Ooh, it's on special, $270. $270 for 750 milliliters. Not even a liter of booze. And $200 by, you know, ice wine, whatever that is. Like, wow. This is crazy. Even the chocolate, like a little chocolate bar is $8. It's just, I don't know, man. I guess they just get you, like, so one of those things, right? I don't know. Anyway, so I'm off to Mexico. Off to Mexico, and then it goes, so Vancouver, Mexico, Mexico, Bogota, and Bogota, Guayaquil. So I'm looking forward to the journey. You know, I bought my little travel pillow.
got this, my dad gave me a camera bag for Christmas. And it is amazing, all the compartments and everything. Just amazing little camera bag. It holds everything I've got. You know, all my chargers and everything. What an awesome little bag, you know, passport pocket. Just perfect for traveling, because my Blackhawk is great and everything, very resilient and robust, but it had no compartments. It just, everything was piled in together, and, you know, my lenses were clanging against each other, and and then everything, of course, sinks to the bottom of your bag, so that one's compartmentalized, so it's really, really good. But anyway, at the airport, very excited, and then I'll be on the beach, probably, tomorrow. I should arrive in Guayaquil at 10 o'clock, and then my adoptive Ecuadorian family will, his cousin, the father, has a cousin that has a taxi service, so I'm going to get a taxi drive from Guayaquil to Montanita, Mangler Alto, which is 3 hours. So it should be pretty good. And we'll be maybe on the beach tomorrow afternoon. We'll see. I will if it's a nice sunset, I will be doing a sunset video. But one other good thing, military discount, of course, didn't pay any baggage fees. And I was overweight. Like I'm bringing a TV. And all kinds of like maple syrup and honey and stuff like that. So that's really heavy. You know, liquid is always heavy, right? But anyway, I'll sign off now. I'll check in Mexico City. Got about a 3 or 4 hour layover. So we'll see you in Mexico City. Ciao.
Okay, so I'm in Mexico City. I'm at the airport. Obviously, it's dark out, so there's no point in looking outside. Big city, I never really realized how big Mexico City is. Like, somebody told me, like, 22 million? I'm like, are you serious? Really? I don't know if I heard that wrong, maybe 2.2 million? Or I don't have to check that out. It could be 22 million, I don't know. The flight from Van was pretty uneventful. But getting here, you've got a clear immigration. Get your bags, take them to a connector belt. Like, they don't check them through. You have to make sure your bags get on the connector belt and go through. And when I was in Vancouver, I asked the AC girl, I said, have they checked all the way through to Guayaquil? And she says, oh yeah. And I was like, oh, okay. So I'm just in a restaurant here so I can plug my laptop in and charge it, because the charging stations out there are all just packed with people, so and I can just have a cup of coffee and sit down in a nice comfy area, because it's expensive, so I can splurge for a Americano. I don't know what it costs, but the flight from Van was about 5 hours. We were a half hour delayed leaving, and he didn't make it any time in the air, but we got in, and I have lots of time for my connector, so another hour before I gotta get on my plane. But it's weird here, like, first I read the thing wrong. Like, it said my flight, then it said everything, then it said G1. And I figured, okay, gate one, you know? So I walk and I go, people are pointing me that way, and I go all the way to number one, and Buddy's like, no, this is domestic. He says, what are you flying? I showed him my boarding pass, because I have my boarding pass. And he's like, oh, you're in Avianca, you're in international flights. He says, oh, that's all the way back over there. So I basically had to walk all the way back, like from 28, from 1 to 28. They get to 28, and I'm like, okay, here it is. And you see it, it says there, it says my flight, it says everything. And I'm like, okay, cool, right on. And then all of a sudden, I find out that, no, it's not that. That's a holding area for the international flights. Then they parcel you off to where you have to be. So a guy came on the speaker, and my broken Spanish, I could understand him. I was like, okay. I didn't have to walk far, but I was like, oh, you know. And there was a few frustrated people getting off the plane who came from Vancouver. It was pretty funny. But anyway, third of the journey's done. Uneventful, benign flight. Although AC, Air Canada Rouge, charge you for everything. The only thing you get for free is like a coffee, like a little thimble cup of coffee, water, you know, juice. They give you pop, but any food stuff's like. And I know Avianca, because you
Because when I flew last year, you get a sandwich. You get a sandwich or, you know, a meal or something, like some kind of chicken or something. I know when I went first class, you get like, you can't afford first class this year. It's like really expensive this year. It was stupid expensive. But you got like really utensils and stuff like that. But anyway, I'll stop yammering. On my way to Bogota and then to Guayaquil. Talk to you in a bit.
Okay, so I'm in Bogota. It's, I don't know what time it is. It's about 6 in the morning. Couldn't sleep on the flight at all, barely. It was a good meal anyway. Nice scrambled egg breakfast. Weird security here, and especially, like they block you off, and they don't let you go to your gate, like, and then they send you to a holding area. I don't know, they must have security issues, you know, they're worried about people, I don't know, going where they're not supposed to, I guess, but seem to be that way in Mexico City. But anyway, I just asked, and I'm in the right block-off area, so, oh, my eyes feel like onions, they're just burning. Redder than normal, I really have sensitive eyes, but holy crap, I'm really, like, irritated right now. I've been trying to hydrate, so. Anyway, just tired, I guess, you know. I mean, it's been a long day. Well, it's been a long start, really, but Saturday drove down, Sunday, then Monday, well, yesterday started at 2. But it should be a short flight, so I'll be in Ecuador before I know it, and then hopefully my driver is waiting for me and I don't get seen off like I did a couple of years ago, but taxi's $100, door to door, if that's what has to happen. I might rent a car, if because it's like $130 for a week, so I'll just get a car, go back, and then when I take the car back, I'll just take a day bag and just hop on the bus, and because I won't have big bags, but you know, I brought a television. Luggage, two huge luggage pieces, so it's not a big TV, but it's enough for you to fit in the biggest piece of luggage that I had. Smart TV, because they're expensive in Ecuador, that's what I was told, so that's why they wanted me to bring one, so. But yeah, I got two bags full, so don't want to be taking the bus with that. Anyway, we'll talk to you in a bit when we arrive in Ecuador or when I get to the house, depending on how things go.
Well, I'm finally here and finally defrazzled, and I was just 24 hours of hell. Well, not hell, I shouldn't say that. That's a lie. It went really well, actually. And now I'm just going to head to Olan. I'm going to get a ride to Olan. But I'm here and I'm rested because I needed like almost 24 hours of sleep. But we're good to go. Talk to you in a bit.